A storm of laughter shook the circle, even the priest and the sleepy Georgios. The frail man said,
"Perhaps it was a portrait of the Queen."
"Certainly,"
shouted Father Christmas, who was quite carried away.
"After all, in those days it was nothing to couple with a lion, or even a bull. Think of the Minotaur."
An hour later, thinking of the Minotaur, but anxious to walk for an hour in coolness, I wandered on in the direction of Ios Simeon. Night had fallen. The air was still, and I loitered on my way, listening to the owls which echoed one another over the fields. Suddenly two torches shone on me together. I stopped stupidly in their light. They shone in silence, inspecting me, like the twin eyes of some fabulous but hesitant monster. In the end I walked up against them to find a pair of Turkish soldiers, with their rifles unslung, staring at me quizzically. One of them, a heavy man with the wide, smooth-jowled look of the Mongol, said in English,
"Are you alone?"
"Yes."
"Why?"
I faltered and tried. "Nobody would come with me."
"No wonder."
He looked through my papers, which were in order, and there began the slow transformation between official suspicion and natural friendliness. At last he smiled.
"Did you realize you were entering a Turkish area?"
"I'd forgotten." He laughed and shouldered his rifle.
"You're obviously not a Greek."
"I was looking for a place to camp." He said at once,
"Stay in my house. There are snakes round here."
And he walked on with me to the half-lit village.
"I was 4 years in England," he said, "in a canning factory at Newton Abbot, twisting a knob day after day, twist, twist, twist. In the end, I got fed up and came back home. What sort of life is that for a man? Twist, twist, twist."
We reached his house. He had a strangely negroid daughter, who stood in the doorway in a nightdress, sucking her fingers. Two of the four rooms were occupied by goats, which poked their noses through holes in the walls and threatened to break out,